So dear children, today we are going to discuss about Newton's third law of motion, which is very simple and very, very important in physics. What Newton's third law say that to every action, there is equal and opposite reaction. Whenever two bodies are applying force, one body is applying the force on the other. In return, the second body will also apply the force on the first. And these forces are equal in magnitude but opposite in direction. Very common example we can consider like swimming pool. While swimming, we push the water in the backward direction, and in return the water pushes us in the forward direction, right? Same way walking, we are pressing the ground with the force with feet, and then in return the ground pushes us in the forward direction, right? Same way firing a bullet from the gun. When the bullet is being fired from the gun, then the gun will give a jerk in the backward direction. This is known as a required velocity, which we will discuss later on in this chapter. So this is the meaning of Newton's third law. So what Newton's third law says? Newton's third law. To every action, there is equal and opposite reaction. There is equal and opposite reaction. Very, very important. There is equal and opposite reaction. Okay, so this is Newton's third law of motion. We can consider two objects like this. One is this A, another object is here B. Now one force is applied on this, one force will be applied on this. This is the meaning of Newton's third law of motion, right? So how we can mention that? If I am writing, this is acting on B, so this force will be FBA, and this force will be FAB. So what is the meaning and how we will read this? Very important that how we will read this FAB. FAB means force on A due to B. And FBA means force on B due to A. This is the meaning and that how we read. And according to Newton's third law of motion, these forces are equal in magnitude but opposite in direction. So we can write these forces in relation like this, that FAB will be equal to minus of FBA. Very, very important. This we will use later on in the next derivation, that Newton's third law of motion. So I hope this one is understood. So now we are going to discuss about very important derivation of this chapter that we call law of conservation of momentum. So one question can be asked related to this Newton's third law of motion, that we know that to every action there is equal and opposite reaction, that then why these forces do not cancel each other? What I mean, why the net force is not zero? Because in the starting of the chapter we have done already this, that when two equal forces, equal in magnitude but acting on the body in the opposite direction, then the net force is zero. But here what we can say, because these two forces are not acting on the single body, one force is acting on A, one force is acting on B, so how they can cancel each other? This is the reason you will write that we cannot cancel these equations or forces because they are acting on the two different objects. This is the reason for this. Okay, so now very important derivation, that is law of conservation of momentum. Law of conservation of momentum. So what this law says? It says that the total momentum of a system total momentum of a system during collision, we can say. Collision means they are colliding with each other, remains conserved. That we will prove. But what I mean by this, I mean that initial momentum is equal to final momentum, and now we are going to prove this law, that how it is possible in initial momentum is equal to final momentum. So suppose we are having two different bodies. One is A and one is B. Here we have one body A, right? This body is moving, and this body is also moving another body B. Now A is moving with the initial velocity I have considered u, and B is moving with initial velocity ub, right? This scene is before collision. Still they are moving, but they have not collided with each other. This is before collision. Now, as I'm saying, UA is greater than UB. If the speed of the car or the object which is coming in the backward direction, if the speed is zyada, it will move closer to it. And finally, when it reaches closer to it, then they collide with each other like this. This is A and this is B. Now they have collided with each other. And the mass of this body is MB and this is MA. These are the two masses of these bodies. This is the scene during collision. Now they have collided with each other, right? Now, when they will collide with each other, you might have seen jab bhi do cars ek dusre ke sath collide karti hain to wo different directions mein jaati hain, different speed se. Same way here, after collision, the body A and B are moving with different velocity. A is moving with final velocity VA and B is moving with final velocity VB. This is the scene after collision. I hope this is clear to all, that before collision, after collision, right? Now what we are going to prove, that initial momentum is always is equal to final momentum. Because yahan pe jitna momentum tha, this momentum, total momentum, is equal to this total momentum. How? Let us prove that. Now let's talk about body A. Initial momentum of A. We know that initial momentum is equal to mass into initial velocity. Now initial velocity is UA and mass is MA. It will be MA UA. Right? Final momentum of A. Final velocity into mass. Mass will not change. So MA, VA will be the final momentum. Now if I say change in momentum of A, what I can write? MA, that is final momentum of A minus initial momentum of A. So MA, VA minus MA, UA, right? Further, rate of change in momentum of A, it will be MA VA minus MA UA upon time, if T is the time. Clear? Okay, now we are talking about A only. Now we will calculate the force on A. A force on A, kaun si lagegi? We know that there will be two forces acting on it. So force on A, we have mentioned here, force on A ko kaise likhte hain? Force on A due to B, that means FAB. And FAB, force on A due to B, that will be equal to FAB. That we all know from Newton's third law of motion, right? Okay. Now, from Newton's second law of motion, what we can say, rate of change of momentum is equal to external force applied. Now, where is external force? FAB. Where is the rate of change of momentum? Here we have calculated. So, write down. So rate, therefore, according to Newton's second law, according to Newton's second law. But I can write FAB, that is rate of change of momentum is equal to external force. If I am taking force on A, so I will take momentum of A only upon T. Right? This is all about body A. Okay. Now, same way, similarly, I can write for body B. Similarly, no need to write it again. Similarly, FBA. That means now I am calculating force on B due to A. So force on B due to A kitna ho jayega? Momentum, rate of change of momentum of B. So MB VB minus MB UB upon T. I hope till here it is clear. This is our first equation and this is our second equation. First and second equation. Now two forces we have calculated. Now we will use this relation of Newton's third law. What Newton's third law says, two bodies are colliding with each other, then these two bodies will apply the forces on each other. And these forces will be equal in magnitude but opposite in direction. Right? Same thing I have used here. Equal in magnitude but opposite in direction. So what I can say, what I can write about this? Therefore, from Newton's third law, FAB is equal to minus of FBA. Let this equation be third equation, equation number three. Right? Now from equation 1, 2, and 3, I will take the value of FAB from equation 1, FBA from equation 2 and put up here. So it will be MA VA minus MA UA upon T is equal to minus of MB VB minus MB UB over T. Right? So till now, I hope it's clear to all. Now T will be cancelled. So what will be the final result left? It will become MA. What we will do, we will collect U, that means initial velocity on one side, final velocity is on one side. So first of all, MA VA minus MA UA, we will open this bracket, minus sign is there. So it will become minus MB VB plus MB UB. So what I will do, I will take this minus wali term ko us taraf le jaunga and this minus wali is taraf aa jayegi. So what will be the final result? We will get this result MA UA plus MB UB is equal to MB UB plus MB VB. So what is this? This is the initial momentum before collision. And what is this? This is the final momentum after collision. So what we have proved? We have proved that initial momentum before collision is equal to final momentum after collision. This is the meaning of this statement. This is called law of conservation of momentum. I hope this is clear to all. So recoil velocity of gun we can also calculate by using law of conservation of momentum. You can see here on the screen, capital M I have assumed as mass of gun. Small v, capital V is recoil velocity of gun. Recoil velocity means the velocity with which the gun will push us in the backward direction. Small m is the mass of bullet. Small v is the final velocity of the bullet. Small u is the initial velocity of the bullet. Capital U is the initial velocity of gun. Now I have written the result of this derivation by taking the values from my this derivation, jo maine assume kiya, that I have taken because MA UA maine nahi liya. So capital M into plus u means initial momentum. This is the total initial momentum before firing. This is the final momentum after firing. And this law says that the initial momentum is always is equal to final momentum. So I have put up the value before firing. Both were at rest. Therefore, initial velocity jo dono ki hai, that would be zero. I have put up the values here. In this equation, u ki dono ki value zero ki, toh left side is zero. Now I am left only. mv plus mv is equal to zero. V was the required velocity. We have assumed here required velocity capital V. So humne capital V ko usi side rakha, baki quantity wahan. So this is the answer to calculate capital velocity, that is minus mv over m. So how we can calculate the required velocity? Product of mass of bullet into velocity of the bullet divided by mass of gun, and the answer will be negative value. Why? As I told you, negative sign shows that this is a required velocity. That means the gun will give a jerk in the opposite direction to the direction of the bullet fired, right? So this is the meaning of required velocity of gun, and the small derivation, but important derivation for numericals point of view.